The specialty about Paint 3D is 3D objects. So in order to access some basic 3D objects, you can go into 3D shapes. And you don't have to be a 3D expert to use the 3D feature. So you can see that on the right side, there's 3D objects over here. You can just click and drag, and there you go, there's a cube. So you can actually choose edit colors for this. So you can actually go over here, change the edit color right here. You can cut this, you can copy this out, and even paste another cube right there. And you want to see the cube, you go to the 3D view, and there you go, you can see that it is a 3D cube. I'm gonna right click and then click and drag, and you can see that the 3D cube is actually there. So on this point, I can also disable the canvas. So I'm gonna go into the canvas and then disable the canvas altogether if I just want to work with 3D. So you can see that now everything is 3D right there. And now I can go back to 3D shapes. You can see that there are different shapes to select from. So there is 3D object like a sphere right here. There are different other objects like a cone that you can use and so forth. So you can create some basic models right there. There's the donut over there. So you can see that this is quite good. You can even see the reflection giving you a much depth of field. And there are some other models, basic models like men. As you can see, this can be used for some illustration, and a woman right there, just like that. Click over here. There's the dog, a cat, and a fish. There's the dog right there. There's the cat right there. Just some basic elements that you can just use it. So you can also color these out over here. So you can select this, you can edit the color, and then you can also smooth this out or not. So you that is up to you. You can rotate this out just like this, rotate it out over here, and you can even flip this or flip it upside down. So you can rotate this out manually as well, and it actually snaps over here into 90 degrees, and then as you can see 180 degree and so forth, 270. So it actually snaps into place as well. Same goes for this side of a rotation. You can see that it can be rotated long side over here, so you can actually move this out as well. So you can rotate this out by using this tool right here, and this tool in different sides. And this one is placement option. So this is the Z-axis position. So you can actually click and drag, and you can see that you can change the position in the Z-axis. For the other axis, you can simply click and drag it. For the Z-axis, press this and it'll go into other view, and you can see that it'll give a guideline on where to place the object right there. So you can see that it is quite simple. You can also multi-select objects right here, select multiple objects, and then rotate them out as well, just like that, and then place them out in different sections, just like that as well. So over here in the color section, in the edit color, you can see that there are different types of colors that you can choose from. So let's say you can select this color, this matte color, this gloss color, which is a bit of a glossy color, there's the dull metal color, just like that, as you can see. So this works quite well with the 3D objects, as you can see right here. And over here, you can see that there's the dull metal color, there's the polished metal color, as you can see, which is quite shiny. There's the dull metal, gloss, and matte, which is a flat color right there. So that is how you can actually work with 3D models over here. So there are different 3D models, and in further lessons, we're going to see how to draw in 3D and then use the 3D library as well. So that is how you can work with 3D models inside of Paint 3D. Hope you guys learned something as always, and as always, please like, comment, share, and subscribe.